success in life science requires students to be able to develop quantitative reasoning skills. Two new brands that are out from McGraw Hill are the Mason Understanding and Brooker Principles of Biology. Today we're going to show you a demonstration of the new graphing tools that are available to help students develop these key quantitative reasoning skills. To be able to add an assignment, you simply click on the tab, click on the Create New from Question Bank, and since we're using Mason as an example today, in the pop-up you will find the Inquiry and Analysis Bank with Chapter 5 and Chapter 8 currently populated. For the purpose of this demonstration, we're just going to show you Chapter 5 and Chapter 8 and walk you through this a little bit so you can see how amazing these tools are. If we click on the student assignment view, we'll see exactly what the students see and show you the interactivity. The development of quantitative reasoning skills requires students to be able to be taken from a simple beginning place and increasingly become more complex over time. This is how the brain works, and this is why we set these questions up in the way that we do. In this particular scenario, we see students are asked to be able to identify the axes and the variables that are associated with each axis. As students move up through the inquiry and analysis feature, we find that they are required to do some basic mathematical conversions, making inferences from the numbers in the figure. As they continue to move up, the difficulty becomes increasing and more complex, and students are asked to do more sophisticated mathematical processing. Eventually, students are asked to take data from a table and are physically able to plot points on a graph in a way that has not been able to be done before. Then students are asked to analyze and interpret the line that they have just drawn by calculating first slope, and then in this case, to be able to make more sophisticated interpretations and to identify the place in the graph indicated in the question and to type in the correct answer. Another type of graphing problem requires students to be able to manually adjust or to be able to type in answers based on the scenario indicated above. In Chapter 8, we see exactly the same kind of framework as in Chapter 5, where we take students from a low developmental level and we move them up in their sophistication and quantitative reasoning skills. In this case, the applying concepts ask students to identify what type of graph they are working with. And again, they have to be able to identify and calculate slope and to discover what that means. They have to be able to interpret and apply concepts, and in this case, we give a scenario where the slopes have changed, and then students have to be able to analyze what that means. Eventually, they will have to recalculate slope again in the second scenario, and ultimately, they have to come in and draw where they feel a line of best fit would be located given the distribution of points in the graph. Students then are presented with a new modified scenario and have to apply their skills from the earlier stages. So what's the take-home message? Students need to develop quantitative skills to ensure success in life science. Faculty need better tools in order to help students learn. We address both those needs by providing cutting-edge digital tools that explicitly build quantitative reasoning.